Do we want to do another piece from the score?
We could do that.
Sure.
We'd love to. They'd love to. I'm just going to sit here and just bob my head.
We thought we'd take a look at the interrogation scene in episode one in the pod, and how that we were kind of tasked with scoring something that started there and then led to Angela extracting a location in the hallway, and then leads to a gunfight cattle battle scene, which then goes on to another couple more scenes that are pretty aggressive music driven pieces of music that probably is 10 plus minutes, I would imagine, in that episode. And we went from thinking initially that music was going to be a kind of background sprinkling to realizing that no, it's actually going to be pretty featured and driving in certain ways. And then it became, how do we make it so it's not boring and it's not, this was a series of scenes in order that the tension elevates in each one. Some of them, it's a more, in the pod scene, it's a almost psychedelic visual, very strange but fascinating interrogation with lots of images. But needs to have momentum, and it leads from that right into some ass kicking and into a gunfight, into an owl ship chase. How do we maintain and have the restraint so that it can still feel like it's elevating, and you haven't started off at 8 and gone up to 10 30 seconds into it? So I think the directive over the pod scene, Damon, was something that was kind of funky, a beat that was beat driven.
Yeah, I think as Looking Glass is basically interrogating this suspected member of the 7th Cavalry, the idea was to have a bit of like, for lack of a better word, but like a fun touch. Looking Glass is a character who is an expert, a very dry expert interrogator, but Tim Blake Nelson's performance was, you know, had a bit of sort of comedic flair to it, and especially understanding that we wanted a piece of music that built and changed. I did say, like, it should feel a little bit funky. And you were like, you know, message received.
So we'll play a bit of music that starts in the pod, and then we'll show how we kind of build it to be able to have the legs and stamina to last quite a long time.
So this bass line, this is what differentiates the pod from the next two sections, in my mind. The beat is what's the consistent between the three scenes. And the various other sounds really were based around punctuate, Looking Glass taking apart the 7th Cavalry member.
This was all based around a live synth bass that I was playing. Atticus was tweaking, so it was always in motion. And we could make that last. That scene lasted, I don't know how long television scenes last, but it seemed like a pretty long scene. It seemed like it was tough.
I think it was about 2.5 to 3 minutes.
It's long enough that you have to be mindful that it can get static. So we needed enough components in there to keep it interesting. We didn't want to speed up. We wanted to see if we could keep the momentum of that same rhythm and tempo going through the next section, which is pretty radically different imagery. So we took that beat. I'm going to play that out. And we added some new components to it.
So this was the beat that we first heard. Then we added a kind of heavier one underneath. Some sub. Percussion. Off hat.
And because Damon was responding to stuff that wasn't a million miles away from what we would do in Nine Inch Nails, we felt we could veer into, say, some distorted bass and put in a...
And then it became about layering guitars a la Mutum. There's a kind of sexiness to the... You know something's going to go down at the kettle launch. So that was the octave that came in there. Add a drone guitar here. It felt like it needed to be picked up with some kind of weird synth sound that's going to come in here. That's a sister knife, gets to the field and is running through the cattle. And then this part climaxes for a moment as we see the 7th Cavalry extracting their batteries, which would land just about here.
And that leaves us, when the next section comes in, we can then take the tempo up, which gives us a whole other runway to go through.
But what was interesting really about the experience of Watchmen was, like, when people have said, how did you get the sound, or what is the sound? Like Damon alluded to earlier, you knew when it was Watchmen, but episode one, which was an opportunity to dip into a toolbox that we hadn't previously kind of exploited in score, more of a kind of almost an Nine Inch Nails toolbox. You know, episode two opens in the First World War, 1918. So we're in a completely different place, and the music needs to reflect that. And it's actually how the West was really won, played on a out of tune, broken, upright piano that then morphs into the version that you kind of heard there, where we go to Will under the tree. So it, to my mind, there was a kind of sound almost in thirds, like the first three episodes kind of investigated that world. But as we move on, the show is evolving and the music is evolving, and we were in areas and places that we've never ever been before. So although there's you know when it's Watchmen or not, it's not the first episode. By no means, to my mind, illustrates the scope of the whole score or the kind of Watchmen story. Sonically.
That was awesome, guys.